Hello friends, today I am giving a seminar presentation on microwave active components. In that one, we will able to understand the various types of microwave tubes and solid state semiconductor devices. Now these microwave tubes and semiconductor devices are operating 300 megahertz frequency to 300 gigahertz frequency range. Actual microwave frequency range will consider as a 1 gigahertz, or it will start from the 1 gigahertz frequency. Now this is what the overall contents that I am going to cover in this video. That is the first electromagnetic spectrum, various frequency ranges, then use of each frequency range, then different frequency bands which is having frequency of microwave signals, then microwave signal generation, how the signal is generated, then different types of microwave tubes that is used for the microwave transmissions and reception, then we have the different types of some solid state devices that is used in the microwave applications, then how microwave signal is generated in microwave tubes and in solid state device, that also we will see in the video, then different tubes and solid state devices comparison will see are there, then applications of solid state devices, and how this signal will be measured using spectrum analyzer. So this is what the generalized electromagnetic spectrum that is used in the communication system. That is what having the frequencies from low frequency to high frequency, which will be converted into the wavelength. So that wavelength will be start from the 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 20, and frequency is the same, that is what 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 20, and wavelength will be start from the 10 raised to minus 11 to 10 raised to 13 meter. Now in that one we are getting the different applications where the frequencies is used. So some of the frequencies having the AM radio applications, then microwave oven applications, TV remote sensor applications, navigation applications, then ultraviolet light which is from the sun, then some PET scan, then some of the terrestrial gamma rays. So that applications will be coming into the frequency range. The electromagnetic spectrum is the term used by the scientists to describe the entire range of the light that exists. So from frequency radio waves to gamma rays, most of the lights in the universe is invisible to us. So light is a wave alternating electric and magnetic fields which is only visible to us. So these are the some frequency ranges where the frequency band is divided, that is extremely low frequency, ELF, super low frequency, ultra high frequency, very low frequency, medium frequency, then high frequency, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, super high frequency, extremely high frequency, and tremendously high frequency range. So that will be the different frequency bands having its second column is wavelength in meter, and we have seen over there that is the frequencies from ELF to VLF is your audio frequency range, that is audio frequency range is used from the 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz where human can hear the signal, then the frequency from ELF to very high frequency range, that frequency range is called as radio frequency range where modulation technique is used, and then ultra high frequency to extremely high frequency range is called as microwave frequency, that is from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. So that is our microwave frequency where we can transmit our signal in radio and microwave technique subject. Then frequency, which is what tremendously high frequency, is infrared frequency, or used as a infrared light, ultraviolet light, X-rays and gamma rays. Then this is what the use of each frequency range, that is communication with submarines, then submarine communications, then navigations, heart rate monitoring, then clock time signals, then AM broadcasting, FM broadcasting, then some of the short wave broadcasting, then satellite communications, weather monitoring, then in Zigbee, Bluetooth. So this is what we are getting from the slide, that different frequency range applications they are given. Then this is what the microwave frequency band designation, where the name is given, that is our microwave frequency range is divided into sub parts, that is P band, L band, S band, C band, then Ku band, that is V band, and W band, where the all our frequency is divided from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. Then microwave signal generation. So we have the different devices which will generate the microwave signal, that is it is divided into two part, microwave tubes and microwave solid state devices. So microwave tubes contain klystron amplifiers, reflex klystron, magnetron oscillations, and helix traveling wave tubes. In solid state devices, we have gun diode, then microwave transistor, FET, that is field effect transistor, impact diode, trapec diode, then barrier diode, pin diode, that is P intrinsic N layer diode, and tunnel diode. So these are what the two types where microwave frequency or microwave signal is generated. Then we'll see the microwave tubes where the signal is created, that is klystron amplifier, reflex klystron, magnetron and traveling wave tubes, where we will go for the principal application as a velocity modulation. That is what input signal is converted into velocity modulation or velocity, then it is converted into voltage or current conversion. So we have two types of modulation here. First is velocity modulation, and then current or voltage modulation. Then this is what the classifications where microwave tubes is divided. That is what first will be density control tubes, and second is microwave tubes. In microwave tubes, we'll have again cross field tubes and linear beam tubes. So in cross wave field tubes, we'll go for the magnetron, and linear beam tubes will go for the traveling wave tube and klystron. So in density control tubes, we'll have the planar tube, that is triode, are there. Then this is what the klystron tube, which will give us the diagram, that is what construction diagram, and its photograph, how the klystron tube looks like. Now from the diagram itself, we'll get that this is what your cathode, which will generate the electron through the electron gun. Then this supply is applied, negative supplied, so negative is connected to the electron gun, and then it will create the, or it will bombard the electrons on the cavity space. Then this is what the Bunsen cavity, and second will be the catcher cavity. Bunsen cavity will create the bunches of the electrons, and it will be create the velocity, and it will be bombarding towards the collector side. Now this collector will be having the more negative charge, so that this electrons will be forcefully applied towards the collector and reflect back into the catcher cavity. This catcher cavity will catch these electrons and making the bunch of the different electrons created in one cycle. So during one cycle, there will be the three types of electrons generation. First is early electron, late electron, and reference electrons. So reference electrons will be created through the zero, that is excess level. Early electrons will be created to the positive side, and late electrons created from the negative cycle. So reference electron is starting from the excess, so its velocity is constant, and then the electron which is created earlier having the velocity is low, so that it will reach to the catcher because it will be created early. So the time required to the catcher is again will come fasterly, so that velocity will minimized. But late electrons will create late, so that will increase its velocity and it will reach to the catcher within that stipulated time. So these three electrons will be bunched at a catcher cavity, and this will be combined together, and it is taken out at the output of the microwave coaxial. So these three electrons will create the positive and negative signal, which will be amplified are there. So every cycle it will create the three electrons, and the cycle will be continuously repeat. So this is what the basic operation of your klystron amplifier. And then it is what the frequency ranges, and they are given the specification of this klystron, which will be in the range of 100 gigahertz and above. Its bandwidth is what 2 to 4%, and it will create the power up to 50 megawatt, and amplification is done up to the 60 dB. Then it will be acts as a oscillator or as a also amplifier. So oscillator means what? Creation of the signal. So it will create the signal as well as it will amplify the signal. So that is what the klystron is, one of the high power vacuum tubes used in the radar system as an amplifier and oscillator. It is similar to the pipe organ tube, where air in the tubes vibrates and produces the sound energy of the desired frequency. So in klystron, instead of air, electrons are used, which vibrate at desired frequency inside the glass tube and generate the microwave energy. So as earlier I said that it will generate the electrons having late electron, early electron, and reference electrons, and that will generate the output at the catcher cavity. This is what the representation, how this klystron amplifier will be look like. The second is the your reflex klystron. In klystron amplifier, there is a disadvantage is the signal amplification is not a required level. So we'll go for the reflex klystron oscillator, where only one cavity is used, acts as a buncher as well as the cavity as well as the catcher cavity, which is called as the resonant cavity. Now this is what the detail construction of the klystron tube, and this is what the inner structure of the klystron tube, same it will be shown over here. That is what the reflection of the above diagram. It is how the klystron tube will be look like actually. Now in this reflex klystron, we have only the single cavity where the cathode is connected, and that cathode will be generate the electrons. Again it will create the three types of electrons, early, late, and reference electrons. Then that will be this is what the repeller voltage which will be applied negatively through this power supply, and this is what the negative power supply applied to the electron gun. So electron guns will generate the electrons, and that will be come towards the repeller side. So repeller will repel that electrons according to how much velocity is applied from the electron gun, and it will be attract towards the repeller. So when it will be attract towards the repeller, according to the negative voltage, it will be reflect back towards the resonant cavity, and the bunching is done at the resonant cavity site, and that will be captured by the cavity, that is resonant cavity, and it will be taken out at the output site. So this is what the output cavity where we are getting the output signal. So this is the basic generalized operation of reflex klystron. So examination point of view, this diagram is very important, where internal structure is there, and that is specifications, the range of the frequency, bandwidth, power output, and its amplification, how much it is. So this is what the specification, that is frequency is 4 gigahertz to 200 gigahertz, output power is 220, then amplification is up to again same 60 dB. Third will be what the magnetron, where we'll now go for, not go for the use of any tube, we'll go for the generation of the electrons through the cavity. So that is what the cavity shown, or they're having the 8 different slots. So these slots you can or these cavities you can divide into the n slots also. So that depends on how much slots you are using are there. So this slots will be mentioned, or it is shown in this second diagram, where the cursor is there. So that is what the insulated through the magnet, and this will be rotated according to that, and that it will be create the electron. So this is what the core, where the insulation is connected, or wire is connected through the insulator, and according to that it will be this is what the cathode, where again it will be generate the electrons, and this anode will be create the positive signal, and according to that electric and magnetic field will be created, as shown red and this black line. So when these two will be interfere, or when it will be mixed with each other, there will be the creation of the electric and magnetic field, that is what the electromagnetic signal, and that will be received by the output side, and it will be radiated to the coaxial loop. So then that is connected to the further applications. So this is what the magnetron, which is having the application in ohms, having the frequencies 2.45 gigahertz. Also it is used in the RF heating, when the frequency is again from the 900 megahertz to 2.5 gigahertz. So this is also used in the TV transmitter, radar, and particle accelerators also. This is what the frequency or specification of this magnetron, where we can use that magnetron having the frequency up to 95 gigahertz. Then output power is 10 megawatt, and it will be acts as a single function, that is oscillator. Then this is what the helix tube, where tube, that is what the helix tube, where the output is connected towards the collector side through the helix pipe. Then this helix tube will be create the attenuation, which is what the fixed attenuation, and according to that there will be the signal generation, and that signal will be pass, and that will be interfered through the magnet. So when this electron will be pass from this electron gun towards the collector, this magnet will be generate the magnetic field, and this electron generate the electric field. So this electric and magnetic field will be interfere in the this range, or in the blue region, and it will be create the electron or electromagnetic signal are there, or signal will be automatically created when electric and magnetic field will be combined. This electric and magnetic field is perpendicular to each other, and that will be received at the receiver side, which is what RF output, and you are getting the microwave signal generation are there. So this is a traveling wave tube, which is a specialized vacuum tube that is used for the electrons to amplify the radio frequency signals in the microwave frequency range. Then in traveling wave tube, radio waves interact with the electron beam when traveling down wire or helix, which is surrounded by the beam. So already I told you that that is not the this is the helix wire. So electrons will be flow from this to this point, and the magnetic field will be already created. So when it will be interfere from this to this, that is the blue region, it will create the signal. Then this radio is also amplified by absorbing the power from the beam of electrons when it passes from the tube or from this side to this side. So this is what the basic generalized operation of your traveling helix traveling tube. Then this is what the different comparison of the velocity modulated tube, that is what the different tubes that we have seen it now. So this is what the energy, this is what the frequency range, bandwidth, output power, application, and what is the function of this all tubes. So klystron is already used for the 35 gigahertz, traveling wave tube used for the 95 gigahertz, magnetron also for the same 95 gigahertz. Then bandwidth is 2 to 4%, then it is traveling tube is more, that is 10 to 20%, and magnetron application or bandwidth is any megahertz band. Then output power, it is 50 megawatt for klystron, 1 megawatt for traveling wave tube, and 10 megawatt for the magnetron. Then it's application up to 50, 60 dB, 50 dB respectively for klystron and traveling wave tube. So the klystron may be acts as a only amplifier. Then it is voltage amplifier, wide band, or magnetron is used for the high power oscillator at one frequency. Then solid state device, that is second part of the devices or component, that first is tubes that we have seen, will go for the now for the solid state devices. So we'll have these the solid state devices, transistor, FET, gun oscillator, impact diode, trapped diode, pin diode, tunnel dial, and so on. So this is what the all devices where we are getting the gun diode. Again, second is gun diode. It is assembled that gun diode with different circuits, that is with the horn antenna. Then this is what the gun, that is what the application of the gun used for the microwave components, or we can say it is benches. So this is what the electron gun, it is inserted into this steel pipe, and output is taken through the coaxial, or it is through the loop. And this is what the microwave bench, where the signal is passed and output will be taken at this point. Then this is impact diode, this is gun diode what already will get here. This is what the pin diode, having P intrinsic N layer. Then this is what the different specifications of our different solid state devices, that is gun diode, impact diode, and trapped diode, with respect to the bandwidth, operating frequency, efficiency, output power, then its construction, then its application, where it is used. Then this is what the gun diode, where we can use the N plus layer, which is for heat sink. Then current versus voltage graph, that is VA characteristics, having it is what negative point, that is what it is, gun diode is operating in the negative supply. So negative is that is minus is applied to the P, and positive is applied to the N. So it has what the valley, where at one point your output will be, or current is increased, and after that it will be goes on decreasing, and after one instant the output, that is current, as we increase the voltage, is rapidly increased towards the positive current. And this is what the impact diode, this is what the symbol, that is what the construction detail, what is connected through the P plus Ni, and it is N plus. And this is what the generalized resonant circuit, where it is N plus N, that is drift, then it is N plus and avalanche, and then it is what the positive layer is there. And according to it is P plus P, and it is N and N plus N. So where the this hole and electrons will be operate as the distance will be changed, so accordingly carrier concentration will be vary. So impact and ionization avalanche, that is impact ionization avalanche transient time diode. So having its power semiconductor diode used in high frequency microwave electronics devices. So they have a negative resistance, that already I told you that it is connected in negative polarity, and it is used as oscillator to generate a microwave as well as the amplifiers. Then its frequency range is from 3 gigahertz to 100 gigahertz. Then its advantage is it has a high power capability. Then next will be TRAPEC diode. So it is derived from the trapped plasma avalanche triggered transient mode device. So it is simple PN junction diode, which is what the formation of a trapped space charge plasma within the junction region. Then it is high frequency generator. This is what the structure of the TRAPEC diode, where it is P plus, then it is N plus and N. So signal will be flow according to that. So when we give the current pulse are there, there is a drift space, and that will be create the oscillations or signal are there. So this is what the specifications, where width is 2.5 to 12.5 micrometer of the N type layer. For P type region it is 2.5 to 7.5 micrometer, and its diameter of that diode is 50 to 750 micrometer. So this is what the characteristics of this TRAPEC diode, how the avalanche is happen or plasma avalanche is there. So when it is charged at one point, the extraction will be happen, and the output will be goes on decreasing. Then at one instant again output will be goes on increasing, where extraction is also again done. Here formation of electron is done, so charging is at from A to B, then from B to C it is formation of the signal, C to D again the signal will be decreased, from again D to E extraction is done, and E to F there is a residual extraction. And again from E to F it will be charged, and it will be create the voltage from the G to A. So that is what the output are there. So on the right hand side they are given the explanation how these points will be created, and how the output voltage will be increased or decreased, and how the constant voltage will be created. This is what the same, then the parameters, that is what it will create the power of 1.2 kilowatt at 1.2 gigahertz, maximum frequency that is 75%, and range is 0.5 gigahertz to 50 gigahertz. This is what the graph of the this various microwave sources across the frequency and average power. So this is what the application of the TRAPEC diode used in the different areas. So that is when a plane is landing, during that time it will calculate its location, then its glide path and its minima. According to that, the landing of the plane is there. Then second diagram will be explained how this the current that approach of the what we can say that plane is there. So current approach is there, this one, where it will be measured the distance, Then another is a smart tracking approach is the second point, and third is ILS approach, and last will be the GLID approach, where it will show the different decision heights that apply of different approaches. And this is impact output, that is application used in a small voltage controlled impact oscillators, then low power radar system, then locked amplifiers. So this is what the threat launch, then search, then tracking, discrimination, then again it is in reverse order: search, acquire, track, discrimination, and interrupted and launcher are there. So according to application, we'll get forward biased mode, and it is reverse biased mode or terminal mode. So this is what the basic diagram how this application is operate. This is the transmitter, and it is send a signal through the circulator, and here transmitting antenna is there, that is what radar antenna, and it will transmit the signal, and when object is detected, the signal is reflected back towards the antenna. This antenna will receive the signal, and it is connected through the circulator to the receiver, and accordingly operation is done. This is what the application of gun diode, that is used to the measure the speed of the moving vehicle or cricket ball or there. So this is what the moving vehicle, where we'll measure the its speed, and this is what the baller will throw the ball, and that speed of that ball is measured. This is what the stackler system, how it will be operate. This is what the circuit diagram, that is internal structure are there. Then the signal is measured through the spectrum analyzer, where we'll get the outputs. So at this point we are getting the maximum frequency and maximum output. So at this point we are having the 520 is of the 50 megahertz are there. So spectrum analyzer is used to measure the microwave signal value. Then this is what the time domain versus frequency domain graph. So this time domain we are getting from this side with respect to the amplitude and time, and this is what the frequency domain. So these are perpendicular to each other are there. Then how the signal will be displayed on spectrum analyzer, it is shown in this diagram. So this is what the overall explanation or description of the microwave components. So students will able to learn all these things from this video, and make this video more what we can say the like, so that or you can share this video to other students also, so they will be get the how the microwave devices are, what are the different types of microwave components are present, and how it will be operated. So thank you very much.